Thank you. Mr. Cahill, any questions? Mr. Cahill, I want you to get as close to that microphone as you can, please.
How's this?
Perfect, actually.
Yeah, a little rubber to this, man. Thank you. Earlier you mentioned that stacking of cars were about 1,400 feet. Was that on 202 or 926?
The 1,400 feet is the distance, as it is shown on the conditional use plan, from 202 to the site access along 926.
And when you say 202 to the site access, where on 202 would that be?
From the intersection of 926 and 202, and we'll pull up the site plan. From the intersection of 926 and 202, along 926 to the access intersection, that's the 1,400 feet.
Okay, what about 202 southbound?
202 southbound in reference
to 926.
202 southbound to 926. I'm not sure what distance you're asking.
From the bypass over 202, past Abbey Green, from Abbey Green down 202 south to 926. Are we dealing with 1,400, 2,000, 3,000 feet of traffic at present, times two lanes?
From what initial intersection to 926 along 202?
Jacqueline Drive.
From Jacqueline Drive? I'm not sure what that total distance is. It's certainly much more than 1,400 feet.
Yes, it is. Right now we have current conditions of traffic that's backed up from 926, 202, up to Abbey Green and beyond.
Yes.
Okay, that is not 1,400 feet. It's probably about 3,000 feet, maybe 4,000 feet, times two lanes.
Mr. Cahill, I need a question from you, if you don't mind.
Do we have traffic studies that demonstrate that that is the case?
The traffic study demonstrates the queues that are seen in the field today, yes.
All right, is that queue involving from Jacqueline Drive, south on 202 to 926?
Our study includes the queue that results from the intersection of 202 and 926 up 202, yes.
And you're saying that all you're getting is about 1,400 feet of stacking?
No, that's along 926. That's just intersection spacing that we're talking about.
How much stacking or how many footage lengthwise of vehicles are on 202 from Jacqueline Drive down to 926?
The stacking would be what the distance is.
Do you have any figures on that?
I do not.
Okay. You mentioned, or a gentleman mentioned, Jacqueline Drive. One of the things about Jacqueline Drive is, I believe it is one of these that you consider to be direct savings routes. And Jacqueline Drive presently is defined as a drive. Are you familiar with the definition of drive versus streets and roads? Is there a difference in your opinion between the three of them?
A difference between driveways, streets, and what?
A drive. Jacqueline Drive, the word drive, versus the word street, versus the word road.
They can be used in all different contexts depending on who's applying the name. I believe
the definition of a drive is a limited road, shortness, and it's a winding road that is designed for light traffic.
Objection, that's not a question.
Oh. Is it okay? Can I turn that into a question then? In your opinion, do you consider a drive to be a short road with a short duration meandering that connects with a street, which is a straight road and a lengthy road which carries high traffic compared to a drive that carries low traffic?
No, I don't.
You don't what?
I don't agree that that's a universal definition of the use of applying drive to a roadway.
How do you know that? I've got a definition that I've seen.
Jail. Can't argue with it. You need to ask your question and move on.
Then how do you know that is the case, ma'am?
Objection, relevance. I agree, Mr. Cahill. I'm not sure why any of this is relevant. So
well, it's relevant to...
Hang on, if you wouldn't mind, like you'd ask a different question.
Okay. Yeah, it's been a long night, gentlemen. At the present time, Jaguar, West Pleasant Grove is the only major road that you're planning on using in addition to 926?
At this point, the plan shows an access to 202.
Access on West Pleasant Grove to 202?
An access from the development to 202.
Access from the development onto West Pleasant onto 202, is that correct?
There's both. There are accesses from the development to West Pleasant Grove Road, and there is an access shown from the development directly to 202.
Okay, and you consider West Pleasant Grove to be a very viable access point for traffic coming out of the development?
Yes, it's a public street that the site has frontage to.
Have you been on that road recently, ma'am?
Yes.
It's a little choppy, a little rough, a little beat up.
Objection, I can't even tell if that was a question.
Okay, I'm sorry. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Cahill. Mr. and Mrs. Price, any questions?
Thanks very much. As part of your assessment, was there rationale to Toll Brothers as to the reason for needing two entrance exits off of West Pleasant Grove? Was that a given or some sort of variable that you were asked to assess?
We weren't necessarily asked whether they needed one access or two. But the two accesses satisfy the spacing requirements for access locations, so they are both viable locations.
Okay, and then my question to that is, if that east entrance exit to the development is moved further west, and there are no plans to move the west further west, is there consideration or potential that there would just be one entrance exit?
At this point, two accesses are proposed. It would be the applicant's discretion or decision to change that.
Okay, and that wouldn't be part of your assessment or recommendation?
No, if they decided to change it, we would certainly reevaluate, but that would not be our decision to make.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you, ma'am. Jennifer or Jeffrey Kramer?
Back to site trip assignment figure 4C. Does the, I believe you allotted 5% of the traffic would travel north on New Street and 40% would travel north on 202. Is the traffic that use it, would the traffic coming out of the development to go north on 202 using Jekyll Drive be counted towards that 5% on New Street or the 40% on 202?
Could you repeat that?
Would traffic exiting the development onto West Pleasant Grove Road to go north on 202?
So the 40% that wants to go north on 202?
Yes. Does that include people going through Jekyll Drive?
That would be, that traffic would have to exit the site onto 926 and turn left to go north on 202. And the traffic, you had mentioned the 5% going north on New Street, they could either exit the site on West Pleasant Grove Road and turn to go north on New Street, or exit on 926 and go off New Street. Those would be their options.
So it's not taking into account that people will go on Jacqueline Drive?
To travel north on 202?
Yes.
No.
Why not? That's a common route.
Because there's adequate access provided for them to access the intersection.
Okay. An unrelated question. Given the claim that traffic has decreased on 202 in recent years, have studies been done to determine whether this is because of a local change in traffic patterns or because of the national overall reduction in traffic due to the recession?
I'm not familiar with any specific studies that have been done, but as a professional in the industry, a lot of the traffic volume decreases have been due to other modes of traffic or people telecommuting, working from home, working different hours. That's, you know, a general sense of the reasons why traffic volumes across the country have generally been dropping.
Okay, in your other tables, I noticed that traffic had increased in the non-recession years from 2003 to 2009, and then again from 2013 through 2015 and 2016. Is there any reason to expect that it will not continue to increase regardless of the proposed development?
We can't speculate. There's a whole host of reasons why volumes can go up and down.
What impact will, you know, that increase have on the current traffic numbers, particularly for the commuters who are using the side roads like West Pleasant Grove Road to New Street to avoid the increased backups?
The applicant is required to mitigate their traffic impact.
Okay, but you haven't taken into account the increases that have been going on for the past several years?
We have taken into account the required growth rate subscribed by PennDOT to increase the traffic volumes on all the study roadways from existing conditions to future 2028 design year conditions. That is incorporated in the study.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Mr. Sprouse, any questions? Thank you. Jim McDermott, any questions? I believe Mr. McDermott has left. Dennis or Patricia McFadden, any questions?
Hi. With the proposed elimination of the egress for 202 for the access there, do you feel there's going to be a lot more traffic going utilizing West Pleasant Grove Road? To get into and out of the proposed development?
If the right in from 202 is eliminated, then we would expect that traffic to use West Pleasant Grove Road.
Okay.
Yes.
So will Toll Brothers provide another impact study for West Pleasant Grove Road and West Pleasant Grove Road and New Street to the township?
The study would have to be revised to reflect the proposed access configuration, yes.
Okay. On the redesign of 202 and 926, I know Toll Brothers has said that they would do the construction if the project from PennDOT kind of goes out 2 or 3 years. Since they're both state roads, does Toll Brothers have to wait for the design from PennDOT to do that?
No, so the applicant has committed to complete improvements at that intersection that would mitigate their impact if PennDOT does not proceed with their project, and they would be required to design and submit the design to PennDOT for approval, but they would not wait for PennDOT to design it.
So at a PennDOT meeting a few weeks ago, I asked that same question. They said that Toll Brothers would not be allowed to proceed without with any design of that, any construction of that intersection, because PennDOT is doing the design phase right now.
Objection, here, sir. Well, sir, do you have a question based on?
My comment is based on, I think Mr. Hawes was at the same PennDOT meeting we were at. So anyway, you answered my question. Okay. And one other question, back to the site plan. With the relocation of the 926 access to opposite of Bridalwood, I'm not sure if you can answer this or not. It looks like the access road would probably have to head west along the property line. Is that going to have any impact on the open space, 60% open space?
The configuration would be revised, but they would still have to meet all of the township criteria in terms of open space.
Okay, because it looks like to me it would use more space with that new design. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. McFadden. Carol Weller?
No question.
Thank you, ma'am. All right, so that'll bring me back around to Mr. Adelman. Do you have any redirect? Wouldn't the board go first? Well, I was going to start with you. and see if you had any redirects, but it doesn't matter.
I'd like to reserve my right for the board to ask some questions.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, sir. I don't know who you are. Yes, sir. I apologize. I called your name earlier. I didn't know you would come in at some point. So if you have a question, please feel free.
My business closes at 6:30, and you guys start the meeting every time at 6. So.
My first question is, what is the state's busiest intersection right now?
I can't speak to that.
It was in today's Daily Local. It's 202 and Route 1. Where does 202 and 926 rate?
I can't speak to that.
Okay, you're a traffic engineer.
Objection. Stick to the question, sir.
Sustained, Mr. Gallo. Don't argue with it, please. Just ask the question.
Why wasn't the study performed on a Friday?
It was performed in accordance with the township ordinance criteria.
Are you aware of the current traffic problems along 202 on Friday afternoons between 3 and 6 o'clock?
Yes.
It's pretty severe. It's worse than it is on Thursday, correct?
It could be, it can vary on any given day.
You can come to my store and I'll show you any Friday.
Mr. Gallo, I'm gonna ask again, please. I know this is personal to you. Please don't argue with her.
Okay.
Please just ask her
it
a question.
It is a formal question. My next question is, when you performed the study on September 8th, was there any emergency personnel that had to navigate through rush hour traffic?
Not to my knowledge.
How many accidents occurred that you reported were occurred in 2016 along 202 in that area in 926 and New Street?
I can't speak to the number of crashes.
Okay.
At this time.
Do you expect your development to help or hurt emergency personnel in an emergency situation along 202, New Street, or 926?
I expect it to be neutral because the applicant is required to install improvements that would bring the levels of service and delay to the same or better than without development conditions.
Are you aware of what Chief Bernard has said about the traffic impact?
I am not.
Opinion. In Exhibit B-19, number one, significant amount of traffic backlogs frequently occur between Skiles and 926, potential for more commercial vehicle accidents. My point of the emergency personnel having to respond to a situation could be potentially backlogged. Is that a concern of yours?
Again, the applicant is committed to installing improvements that would result in conditions that are the same or better than without development conditions, therefore mitigating the impact of the development.
Okay. My next question is, are you aware of there's been numerous power outages in this vicinity, and what would happen if the traffic signal loses power?
I can't speak to what's out there today, but battery backup is typically supplied to ensure that a signal operates when the electricity goes out.
Would Toll Brothers be willing to supply a generator if they get full approval for this?
Toll Brothers would follow the requirements of PennDOT for the signal design, who has jurisdiction over that.
Okay. What's required and what's not? If it were to save one life, would Toll Brothers do it, in your opinion? If it's
I can't speak to that. That's not an opinion.
Okay. In your opinion, you quoted before, the study normally is done between November and April, and it was done in September. You said November through April is the preferred time for PennDOT to do the study, you said?
The ordinance requires that the traffic counts be done between November and April, and they were. I'm not sure what September you're referring to.
The traffic study was done on September the 8th.
There's no traffic study dated September 8th.
The one by Kimberly, that's irresponsible. How wide are the lanes currently on 202 north and south at their least point on their, on 202 right now?
Lanes vary.
Okay.
That's not a single dimension.
Okay, that's all my questions. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Gallo. All right, let me ask counsel a question real quick. Are you going to have follow-up questions for the witness? Do you anticipate any further questions?
Planning Commission will have follow-up questions.
Mr. Thompson, are you going to have other questions based on what you've heard?
It's possible.
Okay, I know the board has plenty of questions. So, Mr. Edelman, I know that smile is not what you'd like to see, but...
I'm willing to stay to 10:30.
I realize that. It is 8 minutes of 10. I believe it would be the preference of the board to bring Ms. Klein back. I realize she's not available in June. Is she available for the July, proposed July date?
What was that date again? I'm sorry.
July 25th.
Yes, she is.
Okay. Any objection then to producing her back for continued testimony and questioning on July 25th?
I would like some additional meetings.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you.
My objection would be based on the request to have additional meetings.
I'm not sure I understand the objection. I'm sorry.
I'd like to have additional meetings.
More than July?
Yes.
Oh, that's fine. I'm happy to discuss further out than July.
No. More meetings before July 25th.
Well, I appreciate that, but there's no requirement that we do so, and I don't think it's the board's intention to do so.
Well, you know my objection for the record.
Okay. Well, I need to know whether you're going to produce her on July 25th.
I'll produce her at the next meeting, obviously. When she's available.
Thank you. I appreciate that. All right. Then, is there anything further from the board tonight? He will produce her
when she's available at the next available meeting that she's able to attend, which would be the one after June.